हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ द कंटिन्यूएशन वीडियो फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 7 लिटरेचर लेसन 3 सुवीरा. सो आई एक्सप्लेन यू द फर्स्ट पेज इन माय फर्स्ट वीडियो एंड आई टोल्ड यू अ ब्रीफ अबाउट द ऑथर ऑफ द स्टोरी पारो आनंद. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट मी स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट पेज, सेकेंड पेज ऑफ द बुक. So first I will read. Before that I'll tell you that this paragraph, actually what I am going to read now, it is showing the optimistic attitude of the narrator. Optimistic attitude, positive attitude, because in the previous video, in the previous page, we have seen that the first page we have seen that at the last, when Deepthi told narrator that Suvira Mathur is all time winner and nobody could beat her, so this narrator was cursing herself that why she joined. But this paragraph, though we will get to know more about Suvira Mathur, but we will see that narrator was also thinking positively and she was optimistic. She was having optimistic attitude. So let's read. I eyed the said Miss Mathur. She had long muscular legs and a true runner's easy stride. She had a friendly face which flashed smiles to everyone dressed in a blue t-shirt. But when she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. I tried to shake off my feelings of certain disaster. I had to make a decent go of this. Now I had put myself into this. I may as well give it my best shot. I had won the 800 meters a couple of times in Calcutta. What was the guarantee that Suvira was better and faster than me? Who knows? I could well turn out to be the new heroine of the show, queen of the fast track or something grand like this. So here what we have seen, that narrator looked at Suvira, and here there is a description of Suvira's body structure. From this what we got to know that she has a good body structure of runner, muscular leg. So it is, in true sense, she is, her body structure is also like a runner. And she had a friendly face towards her teammate, those who are wearing blue t-shirt. And she was friendly with her teammate. And one line here mentioned, you see, but when she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. See, children, well-oiled machinery, why? Because she was as fit, as tough as a machine. And also, she is sweating when she is walking. So, she is called oiled machinery. I tried to shake off my feeling of certain disaster. The seeing Suvira and listening about her, little tensed narrator was, but she wanted to just release all her tension. And she was thinking that she was also doing very good in Calcutta when she also won the 800 meters a couple of times. Couple of times means twice. She also won 800 meters race couple of times, twice in Calcutta. So she was, here she was positive, thinking positively. She was telling that there was no guarantee that only Suvira could win the race, because she was telling that might be this time she would be the queen of the, or heroine of the show. That means she would win the race. With such wonderful fanciful thoughts warming the cockles of my heart, I too got up to test my old slightly battered spikes on the new unfamiliar track. No one cheered me on as I warmed up, doing springs and stretches to force the winter chill out from my bones and muscles. Only the power of positive thinking and me were out there, hand in hand. I stopped to catch my breath and watch the 100 meters hurdles and the high jump poles. I somehow had never been able to conquer these two events. But today, I promised myself I would fly. So still here we can see the narrator was quite positive. Here it is written, you see, with such wonderful, fanciful thoughts. What was those wonderful, fanciful, good thoughts? That thought, what we got to know in the just previous paragraph, that she would become the heroine of the show, she would become the queen, she would win the race this time. Why Suvira? So with that thought, she was warming the cockles of my heart. Cockles of my heart, children, although this phrase and words meaning you will get in your book, but you know, in a simple way I can tell you the meaning of cockles of my heart. Means she was content herself, she was feeling good. Content means happy. She was happy, she was feeling happy from her heart, from inside she was feeling happy, thinking those wonderful thought that she would win the race. And she also, she was wearing one old damaged shoes, but still she was confident, because we got to know that the father got a change of his profession. Maybe they were struggling financially that time, so she did not have the opportunity to get a new shoe before this trial, but still she was confident with his old damaged shoes. It is written old, slightly battered spikes, that means old damaged shoes, and that shoes was old, it was damaged, but the track was very much new and unfamiliar. Unfamiliar means the shoes was very much, the track was unknown. Track was unknown to her. Next. So the track was new and unknown to her. No one cheered me on as I warmed up. No one was cheering her because nobody knew that she was a good runner, because she was very new in the school and nobody was encouraging her. But she started doing some exercise. It is written doing springs and stretches. That means started doing some exercise before starting off the race, just to warm up, just to make herself warm. And only the power of positive thinking and me were out there hand in hand. Means there was nobody to support her, no friend, no one. Only what was supporting her? Her positive thinking. And then I stopped to catch my breath and watch the 110 meters hurdles and the high jump poles. And she was just looking at the, she stopped and what exercise she was doing, she stopped and she started seeing that 100 meter hurdles and the high jump poles. I somehow had never been able to conquer these two events, but today I promised myself I would fly. Earlier we got to know that twice in Calcutta she won 800 meters race, but these two events, this 100 meter hurdles and the high jump, this she never won. So but this time she was quite confident, she promised herself. And then the 800 meters race was announced. We drew lots for our lanes and I got lane 3. I had picked the lane right next to Suvira, who was running in lane 4. Not a very auspicious start. A slight tremble shook my dwindling confidence. I admit that for a fleeting moment, I actually considered feigning a faint right there and then. But I could not let myself down that badly, could I? No, I may be a lot of things, but I'm not a chicken. Come on, come on, I coaxed my cold limbs as I did another round of quick springs. I had so much to prove and so much to achieve. So here what we got to know, that then the 800 meters race was announced and every participant, they got their lane, and there the narrator got the third lane, three. I got lane 3 and just beside her the next lane was Suvira's. She was there in the fourth lane. Now, not a very auspicious start. Auspicious start here, you know, here the start was not favorable. Why it was not favorable? Though narrator was trying to make herself with all the positive thoughts to make herself more confident about the race, but still she was having a little doubt about Suvira's performance, because she got to know that she was all time winner. And why the start was not auspicious or favorable, because Suvira was just next to the narrator. And then a slight tremble shook my dwindling confidence. That means seeing Suvira just next to her, the narrator in a way losing her confidence. And for a moment, she was feeling that she would faint. She would faint. Then immediately she again regained her confidence. How? She told herself that I am not a coward person. I am not cowardly. I am not chicken. You will see the meaning of chicken here. Cowardly. So she did not consider herself that she was a coward, that she would come back from the rest seeing Suvira. So she wanted to gain her confidence and she wanted to encourage herself. She was determined that time, and again she did some exercise. She, at the end it is said, you see, I had so much to prove and so much to achieve. That means she wanted to prove herself. As she was new, nobody knew her potential. So there it was for her to prove herself. You see, not only was I new to the school, but also my family, and I had come away from Calcutta in what I viewed as unfortunate circumstances. Suddenly, our comfortable lifestyle had vanished. I knew my parents were putting a lot of financial pressure on themselves by admitting me into this good but expensive school. I had to live up to their expectations now, and mine as well. So here, as she said, that I had to prove, she had to prove there in school. And it is in this paragraph, she, what the narrator said, it was not only to school. The whole family was new there, and they were struggling, especially the parents were struggling financially. They were in a crisis period. They were dealing with some crisis because the profession changed. They went to a different state, a different city. So everything was very different for them, and they were struggling. So she knew that parents, though they were having financial crisis, they put their daughter in a good school, good and expensive school. So she had to prove herself there. So she had to fulfill the expectation of her parents as well as herself. Next page, we will go now. But it is better to do the next page in my next video.